2017 November we were here, and he suggested pink had released, and why not do pink in that? Vinod has the quality of being a sincere and a focused director. They then came up with the script, what we've shot, and there have been made some changes which are very, very organic. Ajith has done a swell job. I mean, he is absolutely brilliant in the film. I mean, God has blessed him with major success, and I'm sure this is one of, besides his talent, this is one of the reasons for him to be such a youth star out here. We've been toying with this for the past 4 or 5 years to do a Tamil film, ever since Ajith did English of English on our thing. You know, me and Sri had met Ajith, and since Sri knew Shalini, and we used to meet very often here whenever we got here to Chennai, there was always an interaction, but nothing really professional was spoken.
Not even before that?
Even before that, we used to meet socially in a restaurant where we used to bump into them and all that. The real bonding started when he came down to Bombay to shoot for English for English.
Okay.
That's the time he came home, and when we chatted, Sri expressed a desire that I want my husband to do a Tamil film, and would you be, so he said 100%, I would be happy doing a Tamil film for you and for your husband. That's where our conversation of doing a film started. And since then we were meeting, interacting, trying to see what, in fact he suggested a few directors, they met me. Nothing really materialized till 2017, when 2017 November we were here, and he suggested pink had released, and why not do pink in Tamil? And we all instantly agreed, because it was a film which we had loved it, liked it, and somehow Sri instantly felt that it will resonate very well with the Tamil audience too. In fact, it will resonate globally. It is a subject which can be identified with any region. And then began my process of acquiring the rights to for the South Indian languages. It took a while, and in the meantime, we met several other directors. And before we had thought of pink, or rather before pink came to our mind, Ajith had sent Vinod also to Bombay. He had narrated one plot, and that time itself, Sri and me decided that Vinod has the quality of being a sincere and a focused director with the plot that he narrated and all that. And we were quite impressed in this, that brief first meeting of 1 hour, 1.5 hour, where he narrated the subject. After that, this pink thing happened. Initially, he was a little reluctant. And before that, we had met several other directors. Some of the other things didn't fall in place. With Vinod initially being reluctant, finally he agreed. He saw a lot of meat and a lot of material in it, and he thought he could work it out in his own way, his interpretation. And he and Ajith started jamming on it, and they then came up with the script, what we've shot, and there have been made some changes which are very, very organic, and they're seamless. You know, some things which have been added will cater to the Tamil audience. There are things which have been added which will satisfy Ajith's fans. And some nuances here and there, some layers here and there have been added. But the soul has been maintained. The main heart of the film remains the same, and Ajith has done a swell job. I mean, he is absolutely brilliant in the film. So are the others. Rangraj Pandey, then the three girls that we have, Shraddha, Abhirami, and that Andrea. All the actors have performed superbly. The four boys. So everything fell in place, and the journey of doing this film was something which was absolutely, you know, smooth. There were no glitches, there were no problem. Everything worked out like a, you know, something which was planned on paper, was executed while it was being shot. There was not a single cancellation, there was not a single moment where we had any kind of a situation where the shooting was held, or there was a pause, or there was a discussion. So everything went off smoothly, and the way I am excited, Ajith is excited, everybody involved in the film is excited. I'm quite sure, you know, Yuvan was the last person who saw the film. He was excited, he was extremely thrilled. And let's hope the audience reacts the same way as we all have reacted. At that point of time, I wanted to consolidate myself first in the Hindi film industry. And then I did, with Ram Gopal Varma, I did collaborate in two Telugu films. And always there was a thought of doing a Tamil film. I mean, between me and Sri, we had discussed and we thought we definitely we were waiting for a right opportunity. And it, Ajith coming into our life was a godsend opportunity. Doing a remake, you know you're on the right track because the film is proved successful in one region. How right it goes depends on many other factors.
Okay.
You know it can't go wrong. I mean, there are some of the films which I've remade, they may not have worked well, but they were not totally rejected. As I told you,
they were not disasters.
They were not disasters. Yeah. They were not even, you see, nothing close to disaster.
Okay. Also.
When I made Charlie Chaplin in Hindi, no entry. The same film was remade in Malayalam. And he followed our screenplay, which was rewritten by Anis Bazmi, who was the director of the film.
Okay.
So it's a give and take. When you see a ready-made film, you add something. Like Vinod has added his own things.
Okay.
Between Ajith and Vinod, they decided what would do, what would go well with the Tamil audience, what will go well with his fans and all that. You feel strongly and you're convinced about it. Why not? There's no harm.
Okay.
You know, in the given parameters, basically without changing the main content, the soul of the film, the heart of the film need not be changed, but the other things can be, the layers can be added, there could be situation which could be tweaked. Yeah, I do. I'm not just a table producer. I do give my inputs when required. I will not necessarily impose my inputs. Only when I'm... You see, I like to participate in every department because I started my career as an assistant editor, then assistant director. I used to be constantly in Lakshmikant Perala's music room. So I've been through all the crafts of filmmaking and it's been almost 40 years I've been at it.
Yeah.
So a little bit of experience I have. So if I don't use the experience for my own films, it would be pointless, this entire journey.
Yeah.
See, process is the same, whether it is Tamil industry or Hindi film industry. You need to be well prepared and you need to have a happy environment on the sets. I mean, formula is simple. Be sincere to your job, be honest, be focused and see that the entire unit is happy. Stick to your commitments. Okay. I have so far experienced only the good part of it.
Okay.
Well, that's a full-blown action-oriented film.
Okay.
Where there are a lot of cars, motor stunts, there is a lot of thrill, a lot of adventure, a lot of chases, there are motorbike chases, you know, lots of, it's basically a wholesome mainstream film which will probably satisfy all across the Tamil audience.
Okay.
Well, as of now, it is just Tamil.
Okay.
And if it is required, probably I'll do it in, I mean, if things work out, I would love to do it in Hindi too. I think he is an exemplary example of a perfect human being. Respectful, dignified, and all heart. I mean, he's not concerned with what others are doing. He's only concerned with his own work. And at the same time, he takes care of everybody around him, gives everybody the due respect, be it the light man, be it the spot boy, be it his colleagues. He's just the same with everybody, which is very, very endearing. And I mean, God has blessed him with major success, and I'm sure this is one of, besides his talent, this is one of the reasons for him to be such a youth star out here. Well, she was the love of my life. She was my lifeline. I miss her every second, every minute. I wouldn't have been here if it wasn't for her. She was a great support. No.
Okay. Thank you, sir.
Okay.